Now, the head of African football, Ahmad Ahmad, has been banned from football for 5 years by FIFA following an ethics investigation by World Soccer's governing body. Ahmad Ahmad, the president of the Confederation of African Football, had been intending to stand in an election in March, but the sport's global governing body said its independent ethics committee has found him guilty of offering and accepting gifts and other benefits and of misappropriation of funds. And other accusations included that Ahmad Ahmad had harassed four female staff and overspent more than $400,000 of CAF on cars in Egypt and Madagascar. Now, looking at this ban from FIFA on Ahmad Ahmad, what will be the effect of it on African football?
First and foremost, I think the fall of Ahmad is a disaster that waited to happen. It's always been there that his fall was imminent. As far back as last year, when he was briefly arrested by the gendarmes in France. So that was an indication that there is a lot happening and that he was just a dead man walking in the streets. So be that as it may, the simple logic of the decision by the CAF Ethics Committee is this. Ahmad Ahmad ceases to be the president of Football Confederation in Africa. Ahmad Ahmad cannot for the election next year, so there's no re-election for him. In short, he is the first one-term president that CAF had had since CAF was founded in 1957. So, and that's it's not good for him, and it also shows that what happened for, in 2017 was just a revolution whereby everybody just teamed up to see off Ayatu, and after that, we all now come back with our individual differences, and that he has really shown because his cup was really overfull.
True. Now, what happens next? Because 5 years is a long time. So does this mean that there's going to be a new president? Because FIFA will not outrightly say that he has been fired from being the president of CAF. So this means that is does this mean there will be a new president of the Confederation of African Football?
It means he's been fired as, I mean, the simple is very simple. He's been fired as the CAF president. And since there's a succession plan, his first vice president, that is Constance Mali Omari of Congo, steps in. And I am sure before the before that tenure finishes as the acting president, he too is going to have a dosage of his own, because both Omari and Ahmad were both jointly accused of wrongdoing at the television right with Lagarde. The television something was done in such a way that it favored the company, the TV company, more than it favored CAF. So, and that FIFA had found very, very wrong. So he too is under investigation, and the outcome may likely come on or before March 12th, when the election will hold. Anyway, Soleimani is not a candidate for that election.
True. Now, looking forward to the elections now, we're hearing feelers that the NFF president in the person of Amadou Pinnick might be interested in the CAF presidential position. Do you think he has what it takes to be the CAF president?
He is no longer a candidate for the CAF presidential election. He has pulled out as far back, I think, 2 weeks ago, and his preferred candidate is Patrice Motsepe of South Africa. He actually said he stepped down for Motsepe. And I think from my own finding within the CAF family, Motsepe is the preferred candidate for that election. So he's the preferred candidate for most of the football federation done in Africa. And, you know, the CAF election is done by simple majority. And that is likely to favor the South African.
All right, let's bring it down to continental competitions now within the African region. Football, take the, for example, the match between Nigeria and Sierra Leone. The Super Eagles players complained about the football pitch where they played on. Do you think the new presidency would have probably put a change on football pitches, how football is played in Africa, both club and in international duties?
The likelihood of that is very slim, because we know within ourselves that the facilities, the infrastructures, and every other thing is lacking in Africa. There's little we can, the incoming president can do. What you can do, the only thing is probably to encourage individual countries to develop pitches, whereby, at least if they want good pitch, that may be good for the national team. But as for clubs, you know that clubs will always like to play in cities or towns where they are domiciled. So that we have a little difficulty. But I don't believe that Nigeria's inability to get full point against Sierra Leone had to do with the pitch. The pitch in Ogbemudia Stadium is very good. If they, if they cannot win in Ogbemudia Stadium, I don't know the magic they actually intended to perform and see themselves winning on a foreign ground and where the pitch is bad. And I'm sure that was not the first time they will be playing on such a pitch in Africa. In Europe, where most of them are domiciled, the pitches may be good, but nobody, no true African player will complain about a bad pitch in Africa, because 90% of pitches in Africa are bad.
Wow. Thank you very much, Kunle Sholaja, for your thoughts on Ahmad Ahmad and, of course, the Super Eagles of Nigeria.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure being with you.
All right.